audience, it is because of the support of my family, especially my mother, who with her honest criticism was able to put my mind through. We had many joyful, debatable and terrible moments, but were able to hold the water. I am also very grateful to the NSS and NASA for providing such a wide platform which allowed me to use technology, learn graphic designing from Mr. Vijay Kumar, and have hands-on experience from Science Ashram, which widened my knowledge. Now, coming to the proposal, it has always been the privilege of astronauts to experience the life in outer space. I am sure you are familiar with ecotourism, nautical tourism, sports tourism, medical tourism. Don't you all think? Space tourism should also fit in the list, as it gives one first-hand experience of the beauty of stars, comets, asteroids and planets. Space tourism will transform the thoughts and perception among humans socially, culturally and emotionally. It will help mankind with new careers for generation of engineers, astronauts, hospitality industry. I'm sure it would open research in space medicine, nanotechnology, physical sciences and many others. Outer space, a magnificent destination, impressive, frightening, yet trek and a quaint, was a review I got from the market survey that I was able to conduct in my living community of 30 people from all lifestyles ranging from 17 to 48 years, both male and female members. They were asked 10 questions each with variety of options. The review I got was that once in a lifetime in zero gravity was the main intention of travel, but safety was a major concern. To create a wow factor in the field of travel, DIADEM evolved. Every experience is a once in a lifetime because you probably have it once, and no matter how hard one tries, nothing can be exactly as the first time. Thus, DIADEM became apparent and self-explanatory in the choice of name. I would like to present to you the protocol for travelling in DIADEM. The quest to discover the unknown, the unapproachable, and the curiosity to know the infinity of space will open candidates take their first step to register. This is followed by a thorough background check, a medical examination and lab test of all the parameters of health conditions is taken up. If all parameters are met, the candidate is issued upon an eligibility certificate which allows him to go under training on launch, space medicine, survival, spacesuit usage and many others. The launch would play an important role in the operations and economy of DIADEM. Initially, DIADEM would be open for 28 guests. Once the astronauts and crew have completed the arrangements and work on board, a rotation system will be established for further work on board. Keeping in mind safety and medical purpose, doctors are part of the crew. Amenities will convey luxurious simplicity, environmental accents, enhanced lighting, hygiene, space to socialize, providing positive vibes in hospitality. The guests in the foyer are briefed about their itinerary and advanced to their allotted room. To reckon a sense of unity and passion to the earth, windows face the earth in the auberge. Hippodrome offers various recreation to experience the life at space. The microgravity games would highlight athletic as well as board games. For example, Lagori Kabaddi can bring about togetherness and a friendship among guests. Hopscotch could strengthen muscles, improve motor skills and develop spatial awareness. Board games will make a sense of togetherness and relaxation and can lower blood pressure and reduce the risk of mental diseases. A sample itinerary on DIADEM gives a perusal of all facilities available on board. The itinerary is fixed for a week in accordance with the market survey, in which 75% desired so. Days are filled with experiences like earth gazing, mock sites, experience zero gravity, eat and prepare food in space, recording earth shadows and interaction with astronauts at the recreation center. The guests have to also undergo a post-medical flight checkup on their stay on DIADEM. The reality to all mentioned so far is only feasible with a proper location and life support system. DIADEM is to be based at low Earth orbit It has the most desirous design influx, with all the balance of qualities lying in a single torus, familiar in everyday life as the shape of a donut. Thus chosen as it is economical and offers better aesthetic and architectural property for having enhanced internal arrangements such as zero gravity and recreation. In redundancy, in the event of an accident, two docking ports are provided, one at the center and the other at the rear of the foyer. Solar panels, radiation protective glass windows, artificial gravity with centrifugal force, alternate source of energy through helium reactor, sensor input fire control system, passive noise system and shield from radiation are all prime aspects in DIADEM. Now coming to the important aspect, economy. Scrutinizing the market survey revealed that only the high net worth individual will be capable of buying the tickets. A percentage of an individual falling in this category is estimated 3-4% in the world. Taking into consideration the Mazda City, which is to be completed by 2030, DIADEM would approximately measure half the size and have a smaller number of occupants. However, research, transport of materials and construction, and the location to the outer space would be railroad for construction. Space law, standards of travel and training, the responsibility of international federations in suborbital surveillance, insurance for passenger travel in outer space are the art of need, as space tourism is no longer hypothetical but authentic. Nevertheless, the out of the world experience would be the main source of income for DIADEM. It is also clear that the sales of tickets will not suffice, as a large amount of money would be needed for providing better facilities and upkeep of DIADEM. Hence, other income generating activities need to be welcomed, such as selling excess solar energy supplies back to Earth, conducting research and exploiting resources of the space. If any queries, I'll be able to answer them all at the poster presentation. My speculation of space tourism is not new, but has instilled in me to reach out, alpine my knowledge and initiate a DIADEM in the field of travel. It has indeed inspired me to look beyond my limits. Thank you for listening.